And so I'm glad that you're here too. Okay, I'm being mindful of your time on, you have to get work. And so what I'm gonna have you all do is bring those children up, take them right over here, clothes, and laying in a manger. It says, and suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, which was told to them concerning this child. Your turn.
And all they heard it wondered at those things were told to them by the shepherds.
But Mary kept all these things. Because sometimes in this day and age, children can think it's just all about getting gifts. What am I going to get for Christmas? What was the greatest gift that anybody has ever received?
Jesus the Christ.
That was our lives, for our past and future sins.
Tell me, how much did that gift cost?
His life.
He sacrificed everything.
His everything.
He could have just called upon an angel, and God, he could have walked away from it. He could have said, you know what, it's not worth it. But he gave it up for everybody, even though for 40 days and 40 nights he was tempted by the devil.
Amen. Now, has anybody in here ever been tempted by the devil?
Yeah, several times.
Uh-huh. Okay. Yeah. Is that real? Does the devil tempt people?
Yes.
And does he tempt us to do things that please God?
No.
Always tempts us to do things that...
This is an 8-year-old who just said that the devil tempts him all the time. He's 8 years old. He says the devil tempts him all the time.
Right.
And so what do? You pray to God, right?
Yeah.
Very good.
And then I just tell the devil to shut up.
Okay. And you know that scripture? The scripture say, tell him to get thee behind me, Satan, right? And do you know that we have to do that? Yeah, that's somebody's been teaching him good. Oh, you have. Good job.
Me and Karina.
My whole family, we believe in God.
That's really good. That's really good. And you all, I want to tell you today that even as we gather, well, do we take dollar bills to tell him to buy things when we need stuff? What are we buying with?
Our soul,
we have to ask it into our hearts. I'm looking for another answer. If we want something from God, what do we take to him as we're asking for it? Do I take a $5 bill? A $10 bill? What do you take?
A blessing.
We get blessings when we go. Think about what I'm asking you. In order to receive from God, what do we have to take to him when we ask?
Heart.
What?
A heart.
Our hearts. You're getting close.
I said soul.
You said soul. Getting close.
Ourselves, but he doesn't want nothing from us.
He.
Except for our belief.
The word, we're getting close, except for our belief.
That's all he wants.
That's it. When we ask God for anything, he wants us to ask in faith. Nothing wavering. If we ask God for a pew, with something for you all to sit in, then we want to move that other thing out of the way because we're expecting him to do something there. So when you ask him, and nothing pleases him more than blessing his children. As you're here today, you're here to bless your children. You're going to have to bring them with you. Tell me, did those children have to give you something for you to bless them? Does he give you something in order for you to bless him?
No.
He doesn't. Mm-hmm. Doesn't have a job yet to even give you anything yet, does he?
No.
And when that happens, God said, I want you to come and faith. I want you to come believe. Don't come doubting. Don't come worrying that God is not going to do it. Don't come fearing. But come believing, knowing that God is going to do it for you. And when you do that, if nothing pleases him more, he will open the windows of heaven. Turn your gas on tomorrow. Not paying dime. Spending that time alone with God. Hearing him talk to me, telling me what to do. They turned my gas on that very next day without me having to pay anything. Yours may not be that you need gas today. There might be something else that you need. But what I'm trying to say to you is that if you will believe in God, really put your confidence in him. Glad that you're here. Really put your confidence in him. If you will do that and tell him what it is that you need, take that time. Get along with him. Turn off the TV. Turn off the radio. Don't let anybody talk. Don't let that cell phone get your attention. But tell him what you need. Open up that Bible. And he may not say to you, heat for life. Because what you may not need was heat for life. You may need something else. But he'll direct you to it. And the way will already be open for you as you get there. Am I making sense? Is anybody hearing me? Mm-hmm. Is anybody being blessed? Can you believe what I'm saying? Okay, it works. Okay. There's that big old gift. All right. Now, okay, it's getting close to time. Here's what I need. We need those on the back of your program. You see those Christmas signs? Mm-hmm. Spend time alone with God, just you and God. Can you imagine that? And you were talking about how you've done some bad things sometimes. You're not the only one that has done some bad things. And if it were not for the grace of God, those people that we have that are incarcerated, do you know we could be incarcerated too? The only reason that we're not is that we didn't get caught.
Amen.
And so to be looking down on anybody else, don't do it. Don't do it. So now, spend time with God alone every day. Open up that Bible. It's not good enough just to pray. If I ask you in this room, I'm going to ask you, how many people in this room pray? Raise your hand, please, if you pray. Okay. Almost everybody in this room. It's not good enough just to pray. You got to read that Bible.
And I'm blessed to move back from Oklahoma so that we can be with our family up here.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you. Anybody else with a prayer request? And even a praise report. I'm going to come back through with those praise reports.
I think this place is a blessing here. Church, I want to come and help you guys out.
Thank you.
Fix this place up, and whatever y'all want done, I'll help y'all out.
I have one big praise. My husband finally got his insurance instead of them denying him because of his heart. He finally got it this month.
Hallelujah. That means he can get the medical attention he needs. Thank you, Jesus. That's wonderful. Okay? Anybody else? Prayer requests or praise report?
No.
This little boy was getting ready to go to bed. His mommy said, no, he said, I want to watch something else. And as he said that, mommy said, no, it's time for you to go to bed. She's going to say our prayers. He turned around and he said, y'all need anything as before I pray? Like he knew his prayers was going to be heard and answered. He asked them if they need anything. So today, as we pray on one accord, know God is hearing those prayers and answering. What are you thanking God for now? Yes, to be alive. Anybody else thanking God for anything?
Life.
Yes. Health. Strength.
His sacrifice.
Yes. Mercy.
Caring people like you.
Forgiveness. And his forgiveness always.
Yes, his forgiveness. That's right.
I said caring people like you.
Oh, praise God.
Yes.
Praise God. And this is a professional photographer, you all. Isn't it? Aren't we blessed? The Lord says that's a professional photographer. Any good. We were going to pull out those cell phones.
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, we were going to pull them out, but we didn't have to. The Lord provided. Anybody else with a praise report? They were looking at me for open heart surgery, and the Lord would not let it be so. And I'm standing before you today healed in the name of Jesus. I said, well, yes, I've experienced it. They said, we're going to start the medication right now then. So that when those things happen, is that good medicine? To start it now when I don't have those things happen? The Lord will give you wisdom. No, thank you. Where did I put my shoes and my coat? I'm getting out of here. And the Lord has blessed and kept me here. Thank him, God, that he's the healer. We're just going to do 10 of prayers. We're going to start right here. And as we go through this list, if you feel led to pray, pray. If you don't, you don't have to. Start with you, sister. Well, let's do the Our Father prayer. Yeah. Our Father,
which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
Lord God, you have heard every one of these prayer requests. Even those that are on our hearts, dear God, that we haven't said to anybody else. For you can read our hearts and answer the requests therein. Thank you, God, for your miracle-working power. Thank you, God, for bringing our brother out of the penal situation, and he is free. Lord God, we ask you to keep him free. Help him to make good decisions for his life. We ask you to open up the windows of heaven and pour out for him and his family blessings that they haven't room enough to receive them all. We ask you, God, to give him a good job, Lord, in every way. We ask you to bless every family here, every inmate that's represented here. We ask you, God, to bless the children in a special way. Grow them in wisdom and stature and favor with you, God, and with men. We ask, God, that you would give this, our brother, a new heart. We ask, God, that you would make that possible. Thank you for opening it up so he has insurance that will be able to pay for the treatment that he needs. Now, God, we ask you to bless each person here according to their needs. And we say thank you and praise you for doing it. In the name of Jesus.
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 Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Now there was...